In all of the videos in this series, we've been using the CLICK PID monitor to see what our PID loop was doing. And while you could create a Tran graph or a bar graph on a Cmore HMI to show the same thing, there's a much easier way to do it. The Cmore HMI has a built-in PID Tran graph and PID bar graph ready for you to use. Now, before we see how to do that, we need to get our system set up. I have a computer at this network address connected to an Ethernet switch. You can use any Ethernet switch you want. This one happens to be one of the AutomationDirect industrial stride switches. I have this CLICK PLC at this Ethernet address connected to the switch via port 1, and this Cmore HMI at this network address also connected to the switch. I also have a USB to serial adapter here so I can set up the CLICK PLC's IP address before the network's ready. This video assumes you know how to set up all the IP addressing and just want to learn about the Cmore HMI's PID templates. But if you need a refresher on how to set up the networking, then check out Part B where we show you step-by-step how to do that. Okay, assuming we have the networking set up and we've exported the nicknames from the CLICK PLC, then all we have left to do is create a Cmore project, import the nicknames, and build out the PID faceplate. Let's do it. I'll bring up the Cmore app, make a new project, give it a name. I'll select the panel that we're using in this demo, and select the CLICK PLC Ethernet protocol since that's what we'll be using. Click on Protocol Setup and enter the IP address of the CLICK PLC that we had on that block diagram. Now, it's not the Cmore HMI's IP address, it's the CLICK PLC's address. And hit OK a couple times to exit. Next, we import the nicknames from the CLICK PLC. File, Import Tag Name Database. Find the file that you exported from the CLICK PLC and open it. Make sure the CLICK is selected, select the port the device is on, and hit Import. I'm going to scrunch the app up a little bit so we can see the full HMI screen on our display. Now we just scroll down to the PID bar graph and drop it on the screen. Our process variable is this guy, our set point is this guy, and I'm going to make the process variable green and the set point red so they match the PID monitor that we've been using. We know our process variable will be between room temperature and around 170 degrees, so I'll put 60 to 180 in here with 12 divisions to give us evenly spaced tick marks on the bar graph. And we only need 3 digits and no fractional digits for the tick mark labels. Our output is this guy, and his range is 0 to 100%. The auto manual mode indicator is selected with this guy, and we can put any alarm bit we want here. And of course, you have all the usual formatting options. Okay, that one's done. I'll resize it to fill the screen. Bring up the PID Tran graph and fill out all the same stuff. The process variable nickname and the set point nickname. The output nickname is this and its range. Select the mode status bit and an alarm bit. The rest of this is just formatting. I'm going to change the background to black with black tick marks because it's easier for the video camera to record, and it will also look more like the PID monitor that we've been looking at. I love that I can see a preview of what I'm about to get. Move over to the data tab. Now, this is key. You need to choose a sample rate that's appropriate for your process. I'll put 4 seconds in for ours. Or better yet, you could have the sample rate controlled by the PLC. I'll leave that for you to play with. And let's store 1,000 points and max out the number of samples shown on the display. The key is to play with these guys until you get the display you want. Let's make the x-axis 10 divisions, again to make it look more like the PID monitor that we've been using, and let's force the y-axis to cover just the range we'll be operating in and with an appropriate number of tick marks. Under the Options tab, you can change the visibility of the Tran graph, enable the Start-Stop button, Clear button, and arrow keys. Most importantly, you can log all of this data. Watch this video to learn how to do that. Okay, we're done. I'll resize that guy and send it to the Cmore HMI. Make sure Ethernet is selected and hit Transfer. I'll fast forward through our usual set points by manually entering the values in the PID monitor, and we see the result on both the bar graph and the trend graph, just like we would on the PID monitor that we've been using. And on the trend graph, we can even clear the screen, stop the graph, and scroll backwards and forwards through the data. Well, that ought to be enough to get you started. Now it's time for you to play with all those options to get it to look the way you want. Join me in part B of this video to get a refresher on how to set up the network and export the nicknames from the CLICK PLC. Click here to see all of the videos in this series. Click here to learn about AutomationDirect's free technical support options, and click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.